Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station Update Hour. We're back inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Mission Control Center in Houston, and Flight Director Paul Dye is again here leading the Orbit 2 team of flight controllers through their shift with Josh Matthew in the Capcom seat there next to him. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 31 crew, Commander Oleg Kononenko, U.S. Flight Engineers Don Pettit and Joe Acaba, European Flight Engineer Andre Kuipers, and Russian Flight Engineers Gennady Padanka and Sergey Revin, aren't slowing down as their week wraps up. They're now more than halfway through a day of experiments and maintenance work, which started at 1 a.m. Central Time. They're currently orbiting 258 miles above the Pacific Ocean, heading south towards the very southern tip of South America, which they'll cross over in the next few minutes. After a busy week of SpaceX activities last week, things have returned to normal operations this week, but that doesn't mean that the crew hasn't been busy. Of course, one of the very unique tasks that the station crew worked on was photographing the transit of Venus on Tuesday. They actually stayed up into their sleep period to take the first photos by humans from space of the event, which occurs only twice a century and won't occur again until 2117. Flight engineer Don Pettit prepared for the event before he even left Earth, arranging to take up some special filters that he needed in order to be able to capture the planet Venus crossing between us and the sun on film. He took several hundred pictures over the course of the seven-hour transit, many of which are now available online at venustransit.nasa.gov. Again, that is venustransit.nasa.gov. The week hasn't lacked for science experiments on board the space station either. Over the course of the week, the crew has worked on quite a variety, and they'll add a couple more into the mix today. Flight engineers Joe Acaba and Don Pettit each spent some time on the BASS experiment, which stands for Burning and Suppression of Solids. That experiment tests the hypothesis that, all other things being equal, materials in microgravity burn as well or better than they would in gravity. It's a video here of Pettit working in the Columbus Laboratory at the Microgravity Science Glove Box on that experiment. Acaba, Pettit, and Andre Kuipers all spent some time this week performing runs of the VO2 max experiment on various days. That documents changes in the crew members' maximum oxygen uptake while they're in space. And Acaba also worked with a couple of other experiments aimed at monitoring crew health and fitness while away from Earth, the integrated cardiovascular experiment and the ProK diet experiment. First, there monitors changes in the crew's cardiovascular health during and after their time in space. And the second is aimed at determining whether special diets could be used as an easy way to prevent bone loss in space. Kuipers and Pettit swapped off throughout the week on a long maintenance project they undertook with a Japanese Ryūte rack. That rack houses experiments that investigate fluid physics phenomena in microgravity, measure changes in morphology and growth conditions of crystals, and manipulates temperatures for proteins. Kuipers and Pettit have been working all week to repair its image processing unit's power supply, and they successfully wrapped up that work yesterday. Pettit has also been working for the past 3 days on the amine swing bed experiment. That experiment's working to determine whether a vacuum-regenerated amine system can effectively remove carbon dioxide from the station's air. But its control power unit handler circuit board has blown a fuse that Pettit has been working to replace, and he has now actually wrapped up that work for the day as well. Today, Pettit will be working on an experiment called SPRINT, which evaluates the use of high-intensity, low-volume exercise to minimize loss of muscle, bone, and cardiovascular function during long stays in space. And Kuipers is working with the ALTEA SHIELD project. ALTEA stands for Anomalous Long-Term Effects in Astronauts' Central Nervous System. And this is a portion of the experiment aimed at better understanding the interaction between cosmic rays and brain function, as well as providing an assessment of the radiation environment inside the space station. Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit have just a little more time to fit in their work on the space station. They've been at the station since December, and with 170 days in space and 160 days at the space station, they're coming up now on the end of their stay. They'll be returning to Earth on July 1st. Their crewmates, Akaba, Padaka, and Revan, will have most of their mission still in front of them. They only arrived at the station last month and have now spent 24 days in space and 22 at the station, and they'll be there until September. A couple of weeks after their crewmates leave, Akaba, Padaka, and Revan are going to be joined by what will then be the rest of the Expedition 32 crew, Sonny Williams, Yuri Malenchenko, and Aki Hoshide. Those three are scheduled to launch from Baikonur on July 15th, and they're already in Russia preparing for their departure. Today, they were at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City reviewing flight plans and procedures with Russian specialists. That's what's been going on in space this week, and this is Mission Control Houston.